Hello everybody and welcome back to the final of the news videos that I need to do in my Worthener news catch-up session that I'm doing. We've already covered a whole bunch of the other stuff that I had missed, but now we're going to take a look at the Worthener market and user camouflages. This was released just yesterday on the 16th of March, and it's something that a lot of people have been asking me to cover. I have not looked at it, but it is, as you can see, market and user camouflages. I'm very curious what this is. There was something in the files a little, I don't know, about a month or two back, maybe a little longer, maybe a little less, that somebody had pointed out to me about a marketplace that was apparently being worked on. I didn't know what to think about it. I thought, oh my God, please, no. But it's here now in a development blog, and this will show me whether or not my fears have been proven correct, or if this is actually going to be a cool market system and not your typical marketplace that can destroy an entire game for somebody. I guess we'll find out. Now it says user camouflages, so I'm hoping that this isn't going to be anything like what I am imagining it to be. So let's take a closer look. I haven't read in any of this yet, so this is it's a semi-lengthy. It's even got a little mini frequently asked questions area, which is nice. So excuse me. Let's get started. We are pleased to present our plans to add an exchange for in-game War Thunder items and new opportunities for user-made camouflages in the game. Whoa, what? Exchange for in-game War Thunder items? Wait, does this mean that I can turn in something to get something in return? I don't think I would ever do that. But I guess we'll find out. So does this have to do with vehicles is what I'm saying, like collectible vehicles? It looks like it's all camouflage related. So, okay. Today we want to tell you about our plans for the launch of the War Thunder Market, an in-game market in which players will be able to buy and sell items. When the market launches, all players will be able to buy and sell coupons to get user-made camouflages for vehicles, along with other special in-game items. Ooh, okay, this kind of sounds cool, but we'll get into that later in this dev blog. For now, we'll tell you about the market. Let's go. The War Thunder Market. The War Thunder Market is a place where players can buy and sell War Thunder items between each other. Payments on the market are made with a special in-game currency, Gaijin Coins. Fantastic. Gaijin Coins can be purchased for... what? Oh, okay, rubles, dollars. Okay, I was like, what the hell is this? They're not talking about Silver Lions, are they? Or other currencies. Or earned on the market itself by selling items earned in-game to other players. The new currency, so basically you can buy it with real currency or you can earn it through the game by selling stuff that I hope you can earn in the game. I guess we'll find out. The new currency, Gaijin Coins, is necessary so that users from different countries can easily trade with each other. In the future, it will be possible to spend Gaijin Coins not only on the market, but also on the War Thunder online store. For example, by buying a premium vehicle pack or Golden Eagles. Ooh, okay. That sounds interesting. What can you buy and sell on the market? Not all in-game items can be bought and sold on the market. When the market is launched for trading, trophies with user-made camouflages will be available. We talk about those below. Okay, something I'm extremely interested in because the reason I don't use user-made camouflages is because I used to, but I don't use them anymore because they can't be seen by real players. I like to spend time customizing my vehicle so that people can see what I can see. I don't really, in an MMO like this, I don't really like customizing my character, in this case a vehicle, if other people can't see what time I put into the customization, you know what I mean? I know not everybody feels that way, that tons of people use user-created camouflages. That's just the way that I feel, that's why I don't use user-created camouflages. This could finally be a way to use user camouflages in the game if they are visible to other players and by earning or purchasing them. But, I don't know. Hopefully you can still use user-made camouflages, you know, and not have to do it through the market for those of you that don't, you know, don't, or for those of you that do use these. Also, along with vehicle trophies, which you can buy in the Warbond shop or by using coupons for vehicles and camouflages that you get from these trophies. I doubt any of these are going to be, like, collectible vehicle trophies. It'd be awesome if they were, but I imagine it's just going to be your typical normal Warbond-style vehicle trophies with a premium in it or something. I guess we'll have to find out. New opportunities for user-made camouflages. Okay, this might explain to me what's going on. Previously, it was only possible to implement user-made camos for yourself while other players will still or still saw the standard ones. Yes, exactly. Now some user-made camouflages can be seen by all players in battle. User-made camouflages will be among the first goods on the War Thunder in-game market. Especially for the opening of the market, we've implemented new opportunities for user-made content in the game. Once every few weeks, we'll select a small number of camouflages exhibited on the War Thunder Live platform, and they'll go into the market and into the game. Okay, I see how it works. Okay. That makes sense. You can get a camouflage by unlocking a special trophy. You can get one of those trophies just by playing on a vehicle at rank 3 or above. In order to unlock a trophy, you should purchase a key for it on the market. Oh, okay. God damn it. Opening a trophy with such a key will credit you with a coupon for a camo. Both the trophy and the coupon can be sold on the market, but if you are you... Oh, okay. But if you use the coupon, the camo will be applied to your vehicle and you won't be able to sell it on... Alright, okay, I get it. So, basically, it's kind of going to be like a... I don't want to say like a loot crate, but it's going to be kind of like a loot crate. In the sense that you can earn these crates, right? You can earn these trophies just by playing the game. Like, ooh, I got a trophy. But the sad part is that you can't open them. They are useless because you still have to spend real money to actually open it because you're going to have to buy a key. Okay? But you're not going at the same time, you don't have to spend real money. The idea is, as far as I'm gathering from what I've read so far, the idea is to say I can earn a couple, just say like I earn a trophy or a couple trophies that I can't open. So I go on to the market and I sell them. People buy them and in return I get these Gaijin coins. Then at some point I get a trophy and I have enough Gaijin coins to buy a key. Then I can, so either way, it seems like if it's the way that I'm thinking, you can still play the game and earn them just by playing. You don't have to spend real money. If that is the case, then this is going to be great. Otherwise, it would have been useless to me because I don't like having to be forced to spend money on something like this when they say that you can do it without spending money. So that's how it seems to be just from the way that I'm reading it. We'll have to see for sure. And then it says, of course, if you open the trophy or whatever with the key, that camo will be applied to your vehicle. Now, I'm assuming that this isn't going to be a camouflage that is universal for all vehicles. I'm assuming it's going to be for one specific vehicle, any vehicle in the game, right? Whatever that camouflage was made for. So it could be a vehicle that you're not even using, or a vehicle that... What if it's for a vehicle that you don't even have yet? Maybe that's in the frequently asked questions. Like, what if you get a trophy for a camouflage on some jet and you don't even have that jet yet? You know what I mean? So I'm curious to see how that kind of thing works out. But we'll have to see. Displaying historical camouflages. Oh, okay. Here is something that I want to know. Historical. Now, are these camouflages going to be non-historical? Like wacky, like hot pink Yak-9Ts? Which could be pretty badass. Or are they going to be historical? In the sense, like, with realistic numbers, markings, you know, and such, an insignia. Especially insignia. I highly doubt this is going to finally, you know... Finally, I highly doubt this is finally going to mean we're going to see historical insignia on Axis vehicles in the game, specifically Germans, which, you know, is still very annoying, but I understand why they do it. So I don't need a whole bunch of people fucking trying to tell me again. It's still bullshit, the reason why they don't do it, but I understand why they don't do it, if that makes sense. So I highly doubt we're going to be seeing those historical markings. So let's see. We also want to note that not all user-made camouflages selected for the market will be historical. Oh, really? Okay. We understand that some players don't want to see non-authentic camouflages in battle, so we're adding an option to the game to set which type of camouflages you will be able to see in battle. See, this is the thing I always said that you should have. I always said from whenever, you know, since user camouflages were added to the game and that other players couldn't see them, I said, well, why don't you add an option? Why don't you put in the options menu for player? I did a video on this even. I said, have an option in the options menu so that players can decide whether they want to see them or not. So if players don't want to see swastikas or historical markings, they can turn them off. Or if players don't want to see dicks on planes, they can turn it off. You know, that sort of thing. I always said do that, but they never did. Now it looks like we might actually finally be getting an option like that. You can select between displaying only historical skins, semi-historical, or all. By default, the camouflage display option will be enabled for showing only historical camouflages. But when you set any non-historical camouflage on a vehicle, the display option will switch to in any mode. Okay, so there you go. Pretty cool. They did not explain what I just asked about historical markings and such, but this is a nice idea, so I definitely approve of this, big time. How to earn from camouflage creation. Okay, so this is for players that are actually going to be creating camouflages, so I do not matter in this. Any portion or a portion of the money received from selling keys will be shared between the authors of the camouflages that can be obtained by opening the trophy. Authors will receive their payments but to Gaijin coins. We plan to let authors earn real money after their camouflages have earned a specific amount of Gaijin coins by selling their camos. More details regarding this aspect of the marking can be found here at the updated War Thunder Live contribution agreement. So is it going to be like a limited time thing where only, so, you know, say like 5 people get their camouflages put in the game? And for only a limited time, you can get those, so you have to get in, play, earn them? Or is it going to be like, over time, there's going to be 150 different user camouflages from 150 different people, and you can earn one of literally any of those? You know, how's that going to work? They didn't explain that. So that's something I'm, again, though, FAQ, so it might be answered. And the last section here is how camouflages are selected. So this is for people that are creating them, I'm imagining. Gaijin employees will select camouflages from among these exhibited on the War Thunder Live platform. The criteria used for the selection may include the vehicle's popularity among players, the quality of the work, and how suitable the camouflage is for the game in our view. Authors of camouflages on War Thunder vehicles that want to see their creations in the game and on the market should follow the basic principles of creating in-game content. So no historical markings, essentially. For a camouflage to be a contender for addition to the game, it must not contain forbidden symbols or other graphical or textual elements that contradict the game's rules of conduct, War Thunder's age rating, or international law. So again, no historically accurate decals. Depressing. I can understand, you know, no penises or dicks, so obviously that's what they mean by age rating. No boobies or anything like that, so which would be kind of weird on a plane, but like, in the sense, like, just putting tits all over your plane, that'd be kind of weird. So I don't have a problem with that kind of stuff. Of course, don't forget about quality and continued support for your content. For example, if the requirements for camouflage change, find out how to properly create a camouflage down there. Now, I'm going to skip right to the FAQ because I need to know if some of my questions have been answered or not. Player questions. Question. By what rules do trophies with camouflages drop? What influences the drop chance? Okay, I'm interested. The answer is, trophies will drop in random battles and events. To have a chance of getting a trophy, you have to be using a vehicle with at least rank 3 and have at least 50% activity in the battle. There are currently no modifiers for trophy drop chance. So it's literally completely and utterly random. Like, utterly, completely random. There's no modifiers or anything. Now, one question I have is, why is it rank 3 and above? I understand for most other things, because they don't want players using, you know, the lowest battle rating vehicles, and I guess that's the same reason why here. But what if one of the historical camouflages is for a rank 1 or rank 2 plane? Why do you have to be using a rank 3 or higher vehicle if that's the case? You see what I mean? So that's, I don't really know if I agree fully with the rank 3 at least thing, but I don't know. I'm sure I can get over it. The next question is, I have limited internet. Will downloading camouflages significantly affect this? The answer is, already most of the camouflages that are in-game are present in the game's main client and are downloaded during the mission. So from that point of view, there won't be any significant changes. There you go. Content author question. So it looks like, unfortunately, they didn't answer any of the questions I had, or the one question I had. But for anybody that is going to be a content creator, let's see. The question is, I only get payments if a camouflage I made drops for a player. Answer is, only Gaijin coins received for your work can be exchanged for real money. In this case, that work is camouflages. Next question is, what happens with user-made camouflages that have already been added to the game? Oh, here's something to realize. The answer is, these camouflages are removed from sale for Golden Eagles and may be added to one of the trophies in the future. Players that have bought these camouflages will continue to be able to use them. So there you go. I used to be, I'm mainly only a collector of vehicles in the game. I used to be a camouflage collector when they started doing like limited time camouflages and such, but then they started doing limited time camouflages for races and they started doing it for those, you know, big time events and such. And at that point, I just kind of lost interest in it. I do still try to collect some camouflages that are neat looking if they're limited time. But for the most part, I'm not really much of a camouflage collector anymore, unfortunately, just because there are so many I've missed, especially the race-related ones. We'll have to see. But if they come back, you know, again, just like how I've always been wishing for collectible vehicles, if they come back in this drop system, in this market system, awesome, because then, you know, then you can finally get these vehicles. And if that's, they could, this is so perfect. If they can improve upon this and implement the market system later with collectible vehicles, you know, I mean, you know, and we're not talking the big collectible vehicles. I'm at least talking the really old, really not so unique vehicles, in the sense that they are just modifications of already existing ones, like the Year 2 TATs or the SB2MAs, you know, or the SM79s that were removed from the game. Vehicles like this, they would be perfect on the marketplace. They're not super big, they're not super OP, they're not super unique. They are old and they have been a collectible for a very long time, but they're not exactly event worthy much anymore. You know, so this would be a great place to implement them. So hopefully we do see improvements with the marketplace in the future that may or may not allow for this kind of stuff. We'll have to see. I mean, they did say vehicle trophies, but like I said, I assume that they're just talking about the war bond vehicle trophies, in the sense that it's just a premium vehicle. But we'll have to see for sure. The last question here, or excuse me, this is not the last question. The second to last question is, I'm worried that the ability to earn real money from camouflages will encourage a lot of low quality mass content that all get swamped in. There's no substitute for skill. Creating a camouflage is one thing. Creating a camouflage that will be highly rated by players and the Gaijin team and added to the game is quite another. Authors of mediocre content will quickly abandon their efforts to earn Gaijin coins, gain experience, and create awesome camouflages that players will notice. Yeah, whatever. Okay, and the next question is, this is the last question. Can PS4 players take advantage of this feature? Answer is unfortunately not. I don't know why. Don't get angry at me, but apparently PlayStation 4 will not be able to take part in this. No idea why. They don't explain that. So yeah, the one question that I'm still wondering is specifically how if you don't have to buy a key, if you can sell your trophies, earn the Gaijin coins that way, and then buy a key so that you can open up one of the trophies, if it works that way, or if you have to spend real money. I don't exactly know. But I do look forward to seeing this in the works in the game. So, yeah, there you go. This, I don't know if this is implemented into the game yet or not. I still have not installed my War Thunder client. We'll have to see. Somebody can tell me in the comments below. Otherwise, for right now, I will leave the title as upcoming content because I don't know for sure. But that's going to bring this one to an end, guys. So thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next War Thunder video.
Someday.